Most of you use Photoshop to post-process your images. I'm wondering how many of you may know all the 10 tips I'm gonna show you. Let me know in the comments. Do you know about quick masking? Let's say I want to quickly select everything around the building to make it a bit darker, but I forgot to render the wire mask render element. We can do it manually. For example, by using the quick mask option. To turn this on, we can click here. You can notice that the layer becomes red. Or we can use the Q key shortcut to do the same, which I recommend. And now, with the use of the brush tool, you can paint out the mask. Everything that is red will be removed from the selection. I'm doing it roughly just to show you the idea, but of course, it will need to be more precise. Anyway, using this option is useful because you can easily see what will be and what won't be in the selection. You have to invert colors if you want to do the opposite. I'm using the X key shortcut to do this. With Shift, you can draw a straight line from one point to another. It's pretty useful in this sort of situation. Okay, let's say my mask is ready. Then I need to click Q again to exit the quick mask. Here we go, the selection is ready. I can now adjust this part however I like. I will add some curves as an example, as I said at the beginning that I want to darken up this area. You can see that the effect was added only to the parts we selected. Great! Switch loaded tools are a pretty handy option. This is great if you want to temporarily switch tools for a quick edit. Let me explain why. Let's say I want to use the stamp tool to copy the leaf on the street. Let's create a new layer by using Shift plus Ctrl plus N shortcut. I pick the area of Alt and stamp it in here for instance. You can see that we have this black shadow copied as well and it looks weird. We have to get rid of this. We can erase this area by using the Erase tool, it's the E shortcut. Then we can click the S key to come back to the stamping tool. However, if there is a lot of stamping, changing the tools takes a bit of time, and we can reduce it by using another method. Instead of just clicking the E key, we can press and hold it until we finish. After we release the key, it will automatically come back to the previous tool. It works with other tools as well. I quickly create a new file to show you this better on a simple example. Now, I'm using the brush tool, the B shortcut. And now, I press and hold the E key to use erase for a moment. And at the time I release the key, the brush tool is back. It can save lots of time, don't you think? Now I will show you how you can easily work with layers. More precisely, how you can copy different things across the layers to speed up your workflow. First of all, I will add some adjustments so we have a base to work with. Let's imagine that I want to make the restaurant area stand out even more and change its tone a bit. As I want to change the same area, instead of doing it one more time, I can copy the mask. Hold Alt and copy the mask. With Alt, we can also copy the layers. Just hold Alt and move the layer up or down. Now let's say that I want to add some pirates to the image. I quickly adjust its size and place it somewhere here. You can notice that it is automatically the smart object. To make it more realistic, I add the motion blur effect. Let's adjust it quickly. Also, let's add another one. Again, I adjust its size and position. Now instead of setting up the motion blur one more time, I can copy the filter from one layer to another. We need to click on the thing we want to copy with the Alt key and then place the mouse on the layer we want to copy it to. Here we go. You can see that the same effect is visible on another part. Let me show you one more trick on this file, so the parts don't suit the color palette. I would like to adjust this. I will add the hue saturation adjustment and change the part's color. The adjustment influences the whole image though. Now we can of course add a mask to the part and the problem is solved, but there is a faster way to do it. We can use the Alt key again. Hold the Alt key in between the layers until you will see this arrow. Then, release the key. Now the adjustment layer will work only on the layer below. As you know from the previous tip, you can copy the layer with Alt and use the same trick with another part. This is good, isn't it? Another quick tip. Merging layers with the shortcuts. From time to time, we have to merge the layers, for example, to use a specific filter or to make some adjustments. Instead of looking for the option, we can use shortcuts. By pressing Ctrl plus Shift plus Alt plus E all together at once, we can merge all visible layers. We can also select a couple of layers and use Shift plus Alt plus E to merge only selected layers. To make it more obvious to you, I create two additional layers. One with a black background, and on another one, I will paint something with a white brush. Let's say I want to merge all the layers below. You can see that only the selected layers are merged, and I have the two others on top of them that are not included. Now I will show you some cool shortcuts you can use during masking. I'll use Hue Saturation Adjustment to make it easy for you to see the changes. Let's say I want to desaturate some parts of the image. As the mask is white, it means that the effect influences the whole image. To make the opposite effect, we need it black. To do so, we can invert the colors. Use the Ctrl plus I shortcut. Now with the use of a brush, we can paint in the areas we want to have desaturated in the image. But you can notice this effect is too strong in some places. To control the strength of the effect, we can use the opacity of the brush. We can change the opacity on the slider or type the value we want. But as it typically happens, there is a better and faster way to do so. By clicking the number keys, for example 1, we can change the opacity to 10%. By clicking 2, we have 20%. 5, 50%. And so on. But we can also choose the exact percentage by typing the value quickly, for instance, 78. Try it by yourself, it really works. Now, I will show you how you can quickly fill the selection with the background or foreground color. We can use this method, for instance, when we work on masks. So we can use Ctrl plus Backspace to fill the mask with the background color, in our case, black. Or fill the mask with foreground color by using the Alt plus Backspace shortcut. And now, we can continue working on the mask. We can also use this to fill up the selection, for example. Let's set the foreground color to red. Alt plus Backspace, and here we go. I will change the background color to blue. And by using the Ctrl plus Backspace shortcut, I will fill the selection in the background color. I use these shortcuts a lot in Photoshop. This will be a really quick, but also super handy trick. If you work on a project with lots of layers, sometimes you want to compare the initial and final effects. You can click on the eye icon with Alt to leave only one layer visible, in our case, the original image. By clicking with Alt again on this, I will turn on the rest of the layers back. This way, I can easily switch between the initial and final results to compare how my post-production works. Cool, isn't it? I don't know if you know about this option, but when I found out about this, I was mind blown. Let me explain the situation. So I created the mask on the armchair and I added a solid color so we can easily change it to any color we want. I'm sure you know that we can easily pick the color from the image. But did you know that you can pick the color from any other application on your computer? It can be another image, website, browser, etc. To do so, when you have the eyedropper tool on, you have to hold the left mouse button in Photoshop and move to another application from where you need to copy the color. Pretty useful, for instance, when the client sends you some reference color and you have to adjust it. You don't have to open the image in Photoshop or screenshot something, just use this method. It's awesome, isn't it? Last, but not least, this trick gives you the chance to work on the details and the whole image at once. I have the image open. I can open the same file in the new window. Go to Window, Arrange, and choose this option at the end. This is not a duplicate, this is the same file. Now, you can go to the window again, Arrange, and choose the 2-up vertical. Here we go. Now we have two windows next to each other. And now, on the left-hand side, for example, I can zoom in to work on details. On the other hand, I can zoom out the right-hand side to see the whole image. For example, I may want to change the color of the towel. I can use the solid color again, change the mask to black, and now select the towel. I will choose the color blending mode. And now, I can pick any color I want from the image, for example. I can see how it affects the whole image. Does the color match or not? Instead of zooming in and out every time, I can easily change the detail and see the changes in the whole image. Great, isn't it? If you want to know more about workflow in Photoshop, visit our store. Also, watch other videos on similar topics. Here are my suggestions. Bye-bye!